discourse on healing through music by Dr. Pradeep Baba Sahib Taranekar. At this time, I would like to ask you to please switch your phones on silent or turn them off for the duration of tonight's program. Many of us here are familiar with Dr. Taranekar's extensive contributions to the fields of geology, Samved musicotherapy, and Datta Sampradaya philosophy and literature, among others. I know that any words I might say won't do justice to his extensive body of work, so I leave it to Dr. Taranekar to share more about his work and experiences with us in the course of this talk. Please join me in welcoming Dr. Taranekar, and thank you so much, Baba Kaka, for taking the time to speak with us today. Accompanying Dr. Taranekar today, we have Abhanan Kulkarni on tabla, singers Madhav Rai Prolu and Suparna Damki, and Rohan on harmonium. I apologize for any pronunciation butchering I might have done. So let's give them a warm round of applause and start tonight's program. Thank you.
Thank you, gentlemen, and of course, PL also. Since we know almost we are all from India, so with that light, we begin being a musician for the people. It is our tradition. So just do it maybe the combination of Indian lighting system and Western light, but just by putting that light, we perform and start our discussion. So hum bhavena projalo jnana deepam moola jnanam bhata sampada hrityavi steya bhashvan shashvata sprihatubhyam swatmar jyoti datta etat graha. So we have enlightened our heart, and that light from our heart for this performance to God, so that He should create us and to give us success. Success not to us, but these my youngsters for their future prospects. Starting, I will say, this is also an experiment which I am actually performing rather observing today. When first time I have presented some of my experimental data and our performance, that time Pandit Shashank Gatti, he accompanied me. Pandit Shashank Gatti, he was one of the famous, some 20 years back, sitarist of that Vilas Khani system. And he was the music director of Venus Musical Company, that time, Venus Cassette Company. And our performance we have given in Marathi Vidyan Parishad. So there, one gentleman, of course his secretary, he asked me first day when I went there, are you a musician? I said no. Then, are you a physician? Again I said no. Then, what is the business with this musical healing therapy and all these things? Then I said, I am an environmental management concern. And I have concerned with noise pollution and impact of noise pollution on occupational health hazard. So I am also concerned with healing. That's why I am in this business. So when we asked that secretary of Marathi Vidyan Parishad, we want to perform here in this Vidyan Parishad, this stage of the science conference. They said, how can you perform here? There is nothing scientific. So I said, so see, this is a stage for science and discovery and experimentation. If noise pollution can create adverse impact, why not the good sound? And if we are going to have some experimentation there, presentation, how you can deny? So they approved. Then they asked us to give performance regularly for 3 days. In they told us in presence of doctors, our doctors, doctors from Vidyan Parishad, our patients, and some of our scientists. And after the 3rd day, DD 10 channel cameraman, they were there. And 3 persons they chosen, they asked them, do you feel that the music has got some impact? So one lady, she told, yes, I feel, I got. And that lady, she was a practicing doctor. So I think that was my first success, I could say, that we could perform by music something which will be healing. Again, at the beginning I say, this is not a complete therapy. It is a supporting therapy. So now, let us start our journey from noise pollution impact abatement to Swarit Samgan Chikitsa. That is the ultimate thing which I achieved during my total research for 11 years from 1995 up till 2006 when I had been to Nairobi for particular performance, not performance but for treatment. Now how I turned towards this? So in 1995, as an environmental management consultant, when I visited almost all thermal power stations in Maharashtra and some other states, there was a permanent question. And almost in every brainstorming session or group discussion, but what about this noise pollution impact? And we, as consultant, we have typical answers for debates. What was the problem? Some people say, when we are continuously working with huge generators and we are exposed to that unlimited or rather that beyond the limit sound for a prolonged period, we have certain disorders. You can feel it. What type of disorder? Those disorders we were studying. We have already known those disorders. So it starts from inhalation. Then inhalation for prolonged period, if it has been kept for some period, then it again goes to baggage or some joint pains. And after some period, when these two combinations, they appear again and again, the 3rd thing was insomnia. So from manager level to the workers, foreman, everybody was after me. Tell me something about this. I think since most of them are here, so I can say. People say, साहब हमने तो साहब को बोला मैनेजर साहब को कि सबको तकलीफ हो रहा है तो देरी से नौकरी करना है तो इफ यू वांट टू गिव इट तैयार हो नहीं तो जाओ कहीं शांति के घोल पे इधर नहीं सो देयर आफ्टर सो एज अवर यूजुअल प्रैक्टिस वी यूज टू से सी दैट इज द प्रॉब्लम ऑफ नाइस यू शुड कीप ईयरबड्स फॉर मफलिंग One of the system it is base level that is mostly, as we know in 5 seconds. then most of the people say that after a longer period, they will be chemotherapy, this is typical type of headache. Then we say, okay. You keep carpets in your chamber, and in the area where you are working. And some people say, if there is some space and some instruments or some machinery which is smaller one, you can keep sawdust and weigh it again and again. And you should weigh so that weightless it will absorb sound. Then another problem occurred. People say we are suffering due to asthmatic problems due to that weightless or that dust. Third thing, we say, okay, you can isolate yourself with the isolation chamber, glass chambers. Then the last thing I came to know, which I was not knowing at all since I was journalist working many years and many months together in jungle, there was one syndrome. It was termed as isolation syndrome. So when people used to say that if we work within a glass chamber for a prolonged period, it has some type of certain isolation syndrome. So now, what may be solution? That was another problem for me while I was preparing environmental management plan for that region. So then I took a liberty and I started asking people, what you do to remove this effect? What you do? Then some people frankly told me, we just see song. We just listen songs. Somebody say we listen bhajan. Somebody say we listen ghazal. And most of them, they told me that we are interested in some type of these instruments and all these things. Then I started keeping diary. And if anybody come to me, then I say, do you listen any music? Do you listen any song, bhajan? You think fit, you seem to be fit. Are you a good listener? Do you like music? And people unknowingly told me, yes, I listen this music, I listen this song. So in 95 or 96 that time, some popular songs, I got a compilation of those popular songs. And then I enhanced my diary with some description. What is the problem with you? Have you got abdominal disorder, stomach trouble? Have you got joint pains? Have you got problem of insomnia? Unknowingly they said, yes, I have got this. So after a period of about 6 months and 1 hour, I have got some choice data. I compiled that data and I categorically, statistically evaluated that those persons who were having typical type of joint pains and that thing, their timings were regular. At this particular time of the day, that particular type of their pains, they were unbearable or they were aggressive. And those persons, particular those who were listening music of particular raga, they were having some release. So I am not going for that detail, but then finally I concluded with my own this survey that hindone for joint pains, whether it was a bhajan, it was a ghazal, it was something I say a film music, but whatever may be notations, they were somewhere in a framework, we can say. I don't know about the exact hindone because these are stalwart, they are actual musicians. But when I compared these musics and compilation, then I concluded that, okay, you have got joint pains, you listen this type of bhajan music of this rag. I didn't tell them that this is hindone. But I got it. that Hindu for joint pains, Todi for abdominal disorder, and Darwali for insomnia. That was my variation. But you know, that if a man who is basically scientist and working 24 years up to 94 in the field of science as a scientist, he cannot present and he cannot just quote that, okay, this Hindu is a healing, is a remedy for this noise pollution impact. So then I met Mr. Pandit Shashankar, he was a good person. And I gave him first idea that Panditji, I have an idea. I want to observe what is the effect of Hindu on actually patient who has got joint pains. So when he was residing at Parle, Mumbai, and he was associated with medical surveillors and patients also. One of his cousin, he was a doctor, Dr. Himalay Pantavidya, MD, anesthesiologist. He was practicing doctor. So these two associates with me, then we initially selected these three radars. And 22 patients we have collected. And 2.5 months we have called the patients. I asked Mr. Shishankar that, okay, you perform Hindu and ask these persons how they feel. They will contact their personal physician doctors to take their readings, take their reports, and then you confirm whether he is really feeling or he is just saying, oh, Dr. Babasaheb Taranekar, he is a god man, he is giving his blessings, so okay, I am feeling well. So that was not the case. The doctors, they have prescribed. And I simply told those senior persons, if you think that you are taking 3 tablets per day for your pains, if that quantum comes 2 tablets within a week, or rather 1 tablet within a week, I think that something is really happening. And I tell you, after 2.5 months, we got a systematic data of 22 patients, regular documentation. I am having that documentation of doctors and patients with me. And then those patients, they said openly, they have given their remarks that yes, we are feeling something better. Our doses, they have been reduced. Then doctors have said, okay, without any added medicines, they are feeling good. Then one thing happened. During our practice, Shashankati, I just told Shashankati, see, I want this type of particular presentation. He said, Pradeepji, it is not particular Hindu. You are doing something different. You are asking me. Then I say, I am not going to perform for any recreational song or music. Main ranjak music nahi batana chahta. I want something for healing. Upachar music. I want something upachar. And I am not, I am least bothered about that particular type of your raga or nothing. But he said, I will perform our, I should follow strictly according to the rules of Hindura or strictly according to Todi. So I say, I have got one solution for this. What solution? I say, let us change the name of that particular raga. We created our own raga. And whatever for me, it is a bunch of swara. It is an accumulated swara. We are hammering on the patient. And this is the accumulated bunch. And what the name? So the name will be Healing Hindu. Nobody can perform other than you or me. With the healing hero, no nothing really. If there is Varjaswari there, that is there, because that is part of healing hero. So that way, we created three ragas. Healing hero, then next time healing Tori, and the last one healing Darbari. And I tell you, gentlemen, the cassettes we have prepared, which were actually printed healing hero, healing Tori, and some medical mystics, they came to me. Can we keep this in the market? I said, no, we will not allow. That is, we will not allow, because if it has something good effect, then it may have side effects also. One day we came to know that some lady, she is preparing, she is cooking, and she is singing, or rather listening my healing indoor, and something he wants, then she will go to doctor. And such thing happened. But as we started this type of practicing, then we actually given some random performances. After 2.5 months, regular evaluation of patients, somebody asked me, see, it was closed circuit. Some regular, it was a laboratory analysis you had done. But music is not such a thing that it should be in a closing only. So it should be sampled in a random sample. So then we perform such type of performances in first initially in Bombay at Parjit Vida, then in Kalyan, then Dombivli, then at Indore, then Nagpur. And I used to tell people, see, this is experiment. This is a typical type of experiment. Lecture come demonstration followed by group discussion. If you really feel that something is happening, if you feel that music is working, you can tell us. If you don't think it is that way, it is trash, we are ready to accept. If you want to say you have to change this somewhere, we will accept. So in such type of, after such type of random sampling, finally we perform in Marathi Vidyan operation. And as beginning I say that when the Marathi Vidyan operation has accepted, the doctors have accepted, okay, this your healing indoor, it works. So then the DDTN has taken my interview, Pandit Shashankati, he was also interview. One of the doctor, she gave the interview. She said that, okay, I was suffering for insomnia for a prolonged period, but only by 3 days performance of Pandit Shashankati, this I got some relief. And then Maharashtra Times has given front page cover news. Sangito Charasa Upaya, front page Kanagana, and then time for it. So I said, this was my start from noise pollution impact towards music. And then I came to up to that level. That okay, music. You can sit here. I think this sunlight will be very strong. Or here also. That. Since I am man for environment, so I know such type of things. It is one and a half, yes. Now the second thing, when we have established that healing indoor for joint pains, healing Tori for abdominal disorder, healing Darbari for insomnia, we can beneficially used up to certain extent as a supporting therapy. Then another problem was there. People came to us, asked us, sir, we want to listen this particular type of your healing window. How I could get it? So I didn't advise that you take this my CD and go on. Because I know that is not the actual method of any type of healing or therapeutic system. So I used to send them to Pandit Shashank Bhatti. He was Sikaris. So Panditji said, how is it possible that if somebody patient comes, sir, mera ghutna dukh raha hai, aap mujhe thoda sitaris bana lenge kya? Or if somebody said, okay, I have got an abdominal disorder, can Panditji come to me and give me some performance? Sing that fellow, I want to say Panditji, he was director of Venus Music Company and he rendered some time for me. And he was, of course, he was professional sitarist also. So it was difficult for him also. Now today, if you go in the internet, his site, Sur Sanjeevani, Dr. Taranekar and Dr. Pandit Sheshankar. Then he carried out programs of healing music and all these things. But my problem, that was also there, that I couldn't refer public to go to Pandit Sheshankar and go to his house and ask him for abdominal disorder, this raga, for this raga. And if somebody says, I want to listen to raga at a time, it was very difficult for him. So then I left there itself. And there I have also one problem. When I almost in Indian continent, wherever I have been there, and my field consultant, everybody came to know by TV and all this that Dr. Taranekar, he has done some research in musicology. And most of the musicians also and physicians also, they personally invited me. Everybody said, is there any actually documented record for musicology? This is your invention. And I was also anxious. Is there such documentation? Is there any record? Because without such older records, you cannot approach to a medical college as a pathy. And I was not going to practice pathy. But if this therapy, I have to prove it, it should have certain basic references in some particular type of textbooks, or like some records, or research papers. There are certain research papers in Indian Science Congress. I have got a compilation. I just carefully say, I have got a compilation of this my research about 1,000 pages. My own compilation. I have got it in my personal lab. But still I was searching. Is there any reference in any Western or Eastern book, textbook, medical, Ayurvedic, Sanskrit, which can give me some clue of impact of music and its relationship with health? And one fine morning, I got it. When one of my Ayurvedic Vishal, MD Ayurvedic psychologist friend, he came to me for some of his query, and he gave a book with me. Book before me, he was asking, Doctor sir, I have some query about Charkopta Manas Ayurvedic psychology, because I have published number of papers in environmental psychology in international conferences. So he was anxious. He gave that book. It was first book I have seen. It was Charak Samhita, Sanskrit. So I have gone through that book and just I got a glance and I found that reference. If somebody is really interested to know that book, it is available on the internet also. So the name of that book is Charak Samhita. And there is one chapter. It is termed as Vaman Virechan Ati Yoga. That is excessive hazards of excessive medications or effects of excessive medications. So for that excessive medications, the side effects, the remedial measures which that Sanskrit Granth has given, there is one reference. And that Sanskrit reference is Sam Gandharva Shabdashtra Sadhya Nashasya Prayojaye. That is, in a slang I will say in general language, if a patient who has got sadhyanash, that is almost at the level of unconsciousness, and if you perform typical type of swarit samgan, music of samgan system before that patient, even that patient can be cured. Sam Gandharva Shabdashya Sadhyanashasya Prayojaye. Then I got my another direction. Then I turned toward this Sanskrit book. Then I started searching somebody who can know Samved. Not only Samved, but who can sing Samgana. Then I found Pandit Telan, Telan Kshatri from Gwalior. And he was such a unique fellow that he was master in music also, classical, and he was Samved also. When I met him first time, when I searched him, and when I met him first time, and I asked him, Panditji, I want to listen Sam Gayan, not Samved chanting mantra, because I know Samved chanting mantra, how people do. But I want to know Samved musical performance. And then that fellow, in his temple, He took the Tanpura, classical system, and then he chanted the whole Samved Richa in a typical classical way. The classical performance of Samved, just like our Drupad, Drupada, then we had a performance of Samved with Madhava Mansa. That was it. But the problem was, Panditji had no any intention of musical healing. That was my problem. And he had nothing to do with noise and everything, noise pollution. So for that purpose, it was my duty how I can grab that particular Samgan. So I then learned the Samgan system. Of course, that much which was required for me. And after reaching up a certain level that okay, I can sing particular type of samgaya, which is enough for me, rather I think enough for the patient. I stopped that one type of singing, and then I did a typical type of experiment. What type of experiment? Typical, I say, I performed this samgan in front of PIP aura camera. And two doctors were with me. And I asked them, or other deliverable associates, I asked them, you monitor live monitor, what the orographic changes they are actually taking when I listen this particular, or whether I sing this particular sangha, and what type of changes you are finding. Then after those photographs, taking print out, we went to some doctors and we asked those doctors who were studying that type of sonography or X-ray, that type of art mastery. And then we asked them what it indicates. How these color variations, they reproduce or they indicate what changes are going on. And this type of experiments I have carried out in Human Bioenergy Research Center at Pune. And I got number of times I carried out such. One thing I first time gave to them, that Sangha is when you perform with the help of Gatravina. I didn't heard that word, Gatyavanyayoga. So I searched and searched, whatever guna that may be. Then one gentleman, Sanskrit Pandit, he said, oh, Gatyavanya is nowhere. You will never find any typical Gatyavanya. Like sitar or this instrument. It is within you, that Gatyavanya. And that Gatyavanya, it is a part of Sangha. And what is part Gatyavanya, part of Sangha? It should be, that is the your mudra, a touching of fingers, particular points. That is the Gatra points. And that is the Gatyavanya. So, next time, if you had an opportunity to aid a Sanskrit scholar who has mastery in Sangha, you will observe that when he sing the particular perform this song with mantra, his hands or he is keeping his fingers like this, position. These are the positions where each and every word he performs. Swarik. It is said that it is Swarik. And it is said in Psalm 160 that they are exhibiting swaras with this mudra. So I again search and search, entered in a new field, and I got a field of mudra with Nyan. And therefore only mudra can have also effect on these particular disorders. And finally, where I compiled all this my documentation, and I got a typical my own recipe, that is mantra, mudra and swar. So they I could make out sam gandharva shabdashya sadhyanashya prayoga. So mantra, pick up a mantra, then some mudra and swar. This swar means classical or omkar is also termed as swar. But during that omkar and music, also I got one thing. I first time I realized what is the real meaning of Gayatri. I know everybody knows the Gayatri. But I tell you, Mananatrayate Sav Mantraha. Mantra is the only word, a single word. But if it has been repeatedly chanted, not loudly, but your inner also, it has got certain effect. Mananatrayate Sav Mantraha. Mantra is a bunch of words, but it has got some effect. But if certain words, they have been combined and they have been performed or presented in such a way that they have got some combination of mudra and swara, then it becomes Gayatri and it has got certain different effect. What is the effect? Gayantya trayate sa Gayatri. Gayantya trayate sa Gayatri. If you sing it, then it affects on your body. Trayate. Trayate means certain upachara, healing effect. So that is the Gayatri. Then my problem, just everybody I know that who is sitting here, they know one Gayatri. If teacher, I will ask anybody, he will say, oh yes, I know Tat Sankir Varenyam Bhargo Vadevas Dhimahi. But now I say, after searching of this type of Gayatri, I turned toward a different side and I got a book which is termed as Gayatri Mahatantra, an old book this size. And the first thing which I could get from the book, that book says that one single word it is Gayatri, one single word. It is termed as Daini Gayatri. If it is eight words, it is a Nichet Gayatri. If it is 24 words, it is Samitur Gayatri, as we know. But Gayatri can be a typical combination of mantras. At how much words there may be? There may be 100 words. It is termed as Shatavishtha Gayatri. And then I got one thing, that 100 words, it is a song for us. Now the question was only that way, how this Gayatri we can perform in a particular rag. I was fumbling, rather I was confused. Can anybody sing Gayatri in a particular Indian raga? And can we perform? Then when I gone through the book of somewhere, that means Nadi Shiksha, I got certain different thing which suddenly came to me. Nadi Shiksha, I said that Nad, as we musical in field we say not Nad, that is the sound. That is particularly audible musical sound, that is the word of Nad for Bharatanatyam, Natya Shastra, isn't it? But Samved Sangeet and its original book, that is Naradiya Shiksha, it says Nakaro Prana Vayushtra Dakaro Agni Richate. What does it mean? To Pranavayu, oxygen. It is like what we say. And Agni, that is Jadharagani. When they mix together, they create the energy. And that energy, it is the Nad. That is the real definition of Nad, according to Naradiya Shiksha. And then the Naradish, Narada Mahamuni narrated, Nado Dhinam Mato Jagata. The whole world is totally covered and vyapta. Adhin, it is under Nad. That is, it is because it is energy. And then I got it, what we are doing, Swarish Sangha, that is energy here. Nada. Or whatever we are doing, that is Nada Anusandhana. Anusandhana of Nada, that is energy. And when we are performing music, that is the transformation of certain type of energy to a patient. That is the real meaning I got from that Naradiya Shiksha. Then the Naradiya Shiksha narrated very scripture. What is the difference between our classical music, then Carnatic music, and actually Vedic music? What is the actual difference? So I studied that way, and now I have taken much time also from your performance because people may be interested in your performance also. But here we will stop. Then this was my journey from noise pollution till Samgar. And now we will listen with our colleagues their performance. Then I will join them afterwards with my Vedic musical performance. And then we conclude our today's session. Now, how we have framed this our performance and this presentation? Since I have told that we have chosen three ragas, because I know they will be simple, they will be digestible, adequate for today's talk. So I ask my friends that you just give us a jhalak individually of Hindol, Tori and Darbari as per their own performance system.
You say
that yes, now I give you Hindol, then okay.
Oh, Have a more day, I'll find. Oh.
Your performance. I think I cannot say that how you could feel when Toli Rak Panditji, I don't know, you can be here.
Not
Panditji,
but
Madhav. Madhav, yes. Madhav and Kai, she will be. But if somebody has listened my initial talk, my prayer talk, so you may feel that when Toli it was going on, if you have concentrated on the drug, something going on in your other eye, in bladder, something, if you concentrate on it. It means that is the start of Toli. Then, when she saw that Hindu, Ramya hi sarga hamka. That particular type of taan, which we all know, it is Pandit, it is the greatest some of the songs of Pandit Bhimsen Joshi. So what it look like, the Hindu, it is the particular name of North Indian Jhula. And where the taan and all the swaras, they are performed and all with the tip. Somebody should feel like he is on some particular type of ladder or jhula, and that is history, stimulation it is going on with that swara when he is listening. And the darbari, it is calm and quiet. Now, added with these persons, my colleagues, that they will be severe, I think, when I sing, you will get that they are really good performers. Initially, I said you have not performed. Yeah. But there is gimmick. As my problem, I say, I have a certain problem and then I go for the solution. If only one song, and how you can transform that song at the same time in a different way. I have heard this song, and if somebody asks, you know, sir, I want to, you have given this darbari, but can I perform this song in another rag with this singing? So I don't think that some guru or some pandit he will visit actually. But that is the gimmick. That is the gimmick of Marathi Ramayana. So just having a clear glance. In Marathi Abhanga, there is one stanza, shall I take? Tuka mahe netri keli olakhana tatasthate dhyana vite vare. These are simple words. Now, if we start with darbari, then it goes.
Tuka mahe netri keli tatastho he dhana vide vori. Tatastho he dhana vide vori. Tuka mahane netri keli mokho.
And as a classical system, we can prolong it. Less degree. Pulaam, pulaam.
Tattasthahe dhana viteva.
Then some addition.
Tuka mahe netri
something picture like old picture, then you okay.
Tuka mhane ne trikeri molakhana, tuka mhane ne trikeri keri molakhana, tuka mhane ne trikeri keri molakhana.
But when we go to typical Vartari classical, they have got their own system. And with, you must have heard that Ekadashi Pandharpurvari and those Tara, we say. Because some day before I met Mahesh Kareji. And he has performed very much classic type, beautiful Kirtan also he has performed, I heard about it. And then he said that how he procured those tar from Pandharpur and that area. So there is time of singing and also that perform. And then say,
Tu kaam hai ne ki.
Aroha and Avroha in Vedic music. And we say, There is nothing like in Samved. Samved is simply Aurohatma. Almost all Samved mantra, they are out of, or five swaras. We use seven swaras, sometimes even much more, some two nisha, rather two shuddha, vikrit. So we have got five additional swaras. Regularly common matibra. I answer. We unit. Samgan have no such liberty. They are Aurohatma. Once way, I asked to perform for me a flute to one of my senior colleagues. He asked me how I can sing, how I can perform flute only Auroho. From in only descending order and only five stars. And what should be order? Then I told him, see, this Nargi Shiksha says, Vedo Vajjama Prathama, Vityo Gandharaha, Vityo Rishabha, Chaturdho, Sharaja, Mando, Vidro, Vritika. So, Mogaresa Nidhapo. That is the order. Still he couldn't understand. Then I say, have you heard Tulsi Ramayana? He said, okay, I have. Then I say, just try to follow it. Mangala Bhavanaya Mangala Hari Drausha Dasharata Ajar Bihari. It is only our. So, this is the style. First thing. There is typical one system in Sangha. That is Udgit Gan. Udgit means Omkar. Now everybody will say, yes, we know Omkar. But how Omkar can be sing in a classical way, that is Sangha. And that is a complete school of Sangha. It is termed as Udgit Gan. And when I started studying this Omkar Gan, I came to know that as we perform or we listen to Tanpura, Tanpura had only we got three swaras, Sharaj Madhyam Pancham or Sharaj Pancham, Tivra Sharaj, Samasa, Samasa, Sapasa, Samasa, like that. And some people say Lagan Gandha or some Gandha. In Omkar also that means same thing, three swaras. But Sangha has a typical system. They say you can sing only with three swaras. And that too Omkar. So there is saying, or rather, it is special of specialty of Sangha. Sangha say Vedanam Sangno Rasa. Sangha, it is the ras. Extract of all the Vedas. Samna Udgit Horasa. Udgit Omkar Gayan. Who know the Omkar and its singing? That is the real rust of Samna. So you will be anxious how Omkar can be sing that way. So I will just tell you how a single Omkar. Now when we say Omkar, there are three swaras. A, U, Ma. So when different people, if we ask them, okay, can you chant Omkar with this potency? So, variations. Auma, Auma, Auma. Then, hum. Oh. types you can perform on the card. 26 steps, permutation combination.
This type of music. So the questioner
question was, what type of hearing it is? Is it a musical hearing? It is a mantric hearing? It is a mudra hearing? What type of hearing it is? Because we made a combination. We used to tell the patient, keep this particular type of mudra, then listen to this period and try to follow it or try to again reproduce it as in your actually singing. So that was the effect. So once somebody asked me, what is typical, what is different in this? I say, I have prepared a sutra from this. What is this sutra? This is triple medication, a triple motivation therapy. What are triple motivation? It is sarisamgari. It is known because it has got reference in Charak Sutra, Samagandharva Shabdasya Sadhyanasya Prayoja. So, Samgan has effect on healing, effect on particular occupation health. It is termed as Daivi Upashari Chikitsa in Atharveda. But I say it is the triple motivation therapy. What is triple dose? It is mantric, it is mudra, and it is swara. What is the effect? It creates life. How it works? It creates life. Life means biorhythm. And it creates nad. Nad means nakaro prana vayishcha, dakaro omnirichate, energy. So that is the final effect of this type of healing. That is the reason why here. Then somebody asked me, how it can be? So I say, simple thing, if somebody just call you, you are foolish man. You bloody rascal, I don't, you cannot be praised for such words. But simply I say, if he is a gentleman, so immediately you can see the effect on his face. That is the psychosomatic effect. I say, immediate. Now, if you are talking with somebody at phone here and somebody scrappy from there, immediate that effect can be seen. So, once at my parlor performance, somebody asked me, how such effect mantra can have effect? I say, once somebody she told you are foolish, immediately you got the effect. So mantra, they have a certain impact and they are chanted for certain purpose, definitely will help it. Again the same thing, now if noise pollution has some adverse impact, good music has definitely some good effect. So mantra works. Mantra effect is enhanced by mudra. Why mudra? Because as per this mudra vijnana, I say this is fire element here, then air, then space, then earth, then known to everybody, but that's the water. And when we say, when we join this, it is prana mudra. When we join this, this apana mudra. When this, it is called Dhyanapishvishita. And one mudra, I tell you, a very senior doctor who told me, Mahasaya, you are doing something such type of mudra studies. So I tell you, this mudra, combination of Apana mudra and this Pranavaya mudra, this mudra acts like a sarvira. Then I had some problem or breathing problem. Dr. Kale from Mulat, when I had gone to Nashik, at the age of 76, he just gradually, he could like a lung stress, he could not walk, or rather he climbed those three stairs. And they said, Dr. Sam, you are so senior and you have no any problem. then he, the leading Shivati, and he put a cigarette. She said, how bad the water will work? I said, it is mantra detailed water. It is charged water. But I was not sure whether such water can have any such type of variation. But last year I met Dr. Dev. Dr. Dev, he is also a good scientist at Bombay. When I was discussing with him, he said, see, boss, I knew these are experimental my papers. He showed me two types of waters. This is tap water. I have taken photograph, microscopic photograph, and this is orographic photograph. It is just contaminated and having certain zigzag randomly, such type of contaminants in it. And this is treated water. And this water, it has certain crystalline, typical type crystalline, flowery, transparent type of appearance, flowers like that. So he says, this is treated water. And then Dr. Devi is a senior person. He's actually MD, in practicing now. So I, at least myself, I confirm that, okay, water can have such effect. So, I will not say that everybody should try for it. And if so, they say, Baba Sahib Taranekar, what is proof? So that is no proof here with me. But if you have any wish, usme kya hota hai, thoda sa le liya to dekhte hai kya hota hai. So I, it is clear, it is open to us. You can perform. There is no loss, at least. But that lady came to me, she said, after 3 or 4 months, sir, I am getting ready. And what I am now doing, that lady told, can I give that water to another some or other my cousins or some of my friends? I said, okay, you are brave, my daughter. You can do it. So, I will chant first, every first time, and I expect that everything should chant with you. Only 3 or only 5 times a day, keeping your breath, keeping your breath.
Three, four.
water after listening to that sound through the radio wave. Basically, the electromagnetic wave changing to the radio wave.
Yes.
And it actually frozen in a beautiful crystalline way.
Right. Yes.
Much more ordered crystals than normal water freezing.
Right. I have also seen those photographs. Yes. Very thank you. So, have you heard about how a dowser works? In way you can find water, underground water, or borewells from surface. Simply, there is available society of dowsers also. And I heard, rather, I have got that literature also, one dowser, he was called by White House while he was staying somewhere in Florida. He was an old man, so he couldn't go that way. But the people are other, I think it is about Cambridge University. You are there, very seated in White House. So Cambridge University people called him that, okay, sir, we have a water scarcity. Can you guide for a borewell? That gentleman couldn't go, he was old. He said, just send me a map, plan, your university. Then on table itself at his home, he did plant dowsing and pointed that particular area, and he said that plant in that area. Then those university people took exactly their borewell, and that borewell was successful. The same thing it was repeated with me when I gave water point to PK University, Punjab Rao Krishi Government of Maharashtra, because they had a land of 300 acres. So I gave the point sitting in the VC's room, and just by dowsing on paper, then I ran to the spot with the engineers. I found the spot, and the paper has published, Taranekar has heard the university, government. Anyway, it is a technique, dowsing water. One thing I tell you, it is a traditional Indian technique, not less than 2000 years back. We have got documentation. So, and number of such things. So, that I will try to put forth on Monday. If you are interested, you can join us. And I invite you, because it's a very rare thing. Thank you.
Usually, I don't exhibit such technician instinct, but I am not coming again and again here. So, I will here also, I will show how I can doubt water. Which is kept here. In the type of debate, you can still speak of it.
Okay, so we just got an input from our young fellow that we should announce the place as well. So place is right across this, like diagonally across this, like where we are standing right now. I will definitely like, you know, give the physical address. If anybody is interested, please do that.
Time?
10:30 to 8:30, same time. On Monday, coming Monday.
Once again, thank our artists for joining us today. So firstly, we have Rohan on harmonia. Thank you.
been able to do or like arrange this program, or we couldn't have enjoyed this without him.